God bless you, Brother Dan. Praise the Lord. God is good.
Amen.
It's good to be in church again tonight, this day in September. This, our year is feebly going by.
Amen.
And our life is going by with every second that the clock ticks off. Praise the Lord. It's just good to be here tonight. Good to have Brother Dale back with us tonight.
Good to be here.
I started in this message about 3 weeks ago, I think, from Nebuchadnezzar's dream and all the things, the circumstances that took place back then, because of the image that Nebuchadnezzar wanted built so that he could draw the true worship away from God. He wanted, the devil wants to imitate.
Yes, he
I've
does.
Been preaching this for a long time. The devil wants to imitate. If you want to worship the devil, you're an imitator. If you want to worship the way the devil wants you to worship, you are a false worshiper. And you're being led astray by the most ignorant creation that God ever created, if I can put it like that. I mean, who is the devil but your enemy?
Amen.
And why would you want any part of being like the devil? That God has had to prepare hell for him. A lake of fire that is brought in his mouth all the time. Because the deceiver, the devil, is causing people to be fooled by him. And they're going to spend an endless amount of time there through eternity, a place where time has no end. I'm in the third chapter, and I'm going to start back up at the 19th verse of Daniel. And I don't know, today I said that I'd probably finish up tonight, but I'm not sure about that. It depends on the Holy Ghost. You know, I've been talking about this thing that Jesus done on the cross of Calvary for a long time. He came here with a testament, a new testament.
Yes.
With a will.
Amen.
He come here with the will of the Father.
Amen.
In that will, if you're born again, you're born into the family of God.
Yes.
If you're born into the family of God, the Bible says you're an heir of
Amen.
God.
Amen.
All the Lord Amen. Was really laying this on me this afternoon. An heir of God.
Yes.
Join there with Jesus
Amen.
Christ.
Amen.
Do you know what? All the glory of God. I'm an heir of that.
Yes.
And every secret that God has got,
Amen.
I'm an heir of that.
Amen.
One day, you might think I'm done now, but I told Sister Jeanette, I'm just an old chunk of coal right now, but I'm going to be a diamond
Amen.
Someday.
Yes, Amen. I think you're a diamond now.
And I tell you what, this God that we're preaching, that we're singing about, that we're here worshiping, He is a God to be praised.
Amen.
We need to realize what Jesus done on the cross of Calvary.
Amen.
He set us free.
Amen.
Martin Luther King used to talk about being free. We are free. He said, I came to set you free from the curse.
Yes.
The curse of sin and death.
Amen.
Let me tell you something. I'm going to confess something to you tonight. I was a sinner one day. And Jesus Christ died on the cross of Calvary that I didn't have to pay for my sins that I committed. I'm so unworthy. But Jesus came and he paid the price. He paid the price 2,000 years ago on the cross of Calvary. He paid the price and he set us free there. The Bible says, he whom the Son sets free is free indeed. And I want to tell you tonight that I'm an heir. And I'm just as rich as I can be. You may not be able to see it right now, but by faith, I've got whatever heirship there is in the kingdom of heaven. I've got that. And this old king back here, Nebuchadnezzar, he was possessed by the devil. I mean, his ideas was ideas of the devil, what the devil put in his mind.
That's right.
But God said he raised up this king for a purpose. And let me tell you something. I'm thankful. Praise the Lord. I'm thankful that God didn't raise me up for a reason like that. God raised me up to praise him, to glorify Amen. Him, Amen. To preach the holy word Amen. Of God, Amen. To preach the truth.
Yes,
and
he
raised you up for
Amen.
That. And let me tell you something. We need to praise him and glorify him because for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten
Amen.
Son, that whosoever believeth
Amen.
In him should not perish. But have everlasting
Hallelujah.
Life. If that's not enough to get you fired up tonight,
Amen.
I don't know what it would take. Just the thoughts of God in my mind, the way that my mind imagines God is enough any day of the week for me to throw up my hands and start praising and glorifying him because his presence is just as real as they can be.
Praise Amen. God. Amen.
He's the only thing that lasts in this earth.
That's right.
I've had a few new
Amen.
Things in my life, and not a one of them stayed new after the first day I got it. And most of them, after I got them the first day, I thought, why?
Yeah.
Why did I go buy that?
Yeah.
Did I really need it?
Yeah.
Or did I just want something pretty and new.
Amen.
All this thing that we listen to so much, Jesus said, my sheep know my voice, and they will not follow.
Amen.
But we can get the idea about wanting something new, and we think, God wants me to get that. And then after we get it, we think, God didn't want me to get in debt. But we don't think about the debt when we get the things that we lust after. That's all it amounts to.
That's true.
If we don't walk in the Spirit, we'll fulfill the lust of the flesh. Okay, I'm going to get into this, and I'm going to preach the truth, what God wants me to preach tonight. So, open up your ears. I'm going to preach to you about Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. And I'm going to compare them with the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. I'm going to tell you that we're living in a time when we're going to have to be like Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. And that we're going to have to believe that the God that we're serving can take us through the fire. If the fire is out there in front of us and God sees fit that he's going to get glory out of this, look how much glory he got out of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, the three Jewish boys, the Bible calls them Jewish children, that put their trust in God. The Bible says the rest of the Jewish nation was far away from serving God, far away. And these three, counting Daniel, there was four that had set out that they was going to serve God, and that there wasn't anything on earth that was going to change their mind. Is your mind that made up right now that you're going to sell out to God, and that you're going to put your trust in him, and that if it comes down to this old body of perishing, that you're not going to let that stand between you and God? If it comes down to the place to where you're going to have to say, yes, I stand for the Lord Jesus Christ. I believe that he is the way to heaven, and there is no other way. I believe that that's what Shadrach and Meshach and Abednego was thinking that day when they stood before the king, and they said, oh, king, we won't be careful about how we answer you. There's going to be a day when we may stand in the presence of some ruler, and he's going to say, do you choose to worship this image that I've got set up, or are you going to stick to the one that you worship? I believe it's coming in the near future. And there's some countries right now in the world that I've been preaching about that this very thing is taking place. They're having to make a choice in life and death as far as the body goes. But the Bible tells us that we don't need to be concerned about what takes place after we leave this body. Mm-hmm. Because if we're where we should be with God, that we're going to be with him through eternity. Amen. From now on. Amen. And that this body is just temporary, but this old body is going to be raised up in an instant, in a twinkling of an eye, when the grave burst open and the dead in Christ shall rise first, and then the dead in Christ, the ones that are alive and remain, they're going to be called up to be with him. There's going to be a miracle take place. But the ones, the bodies of the saints that are gone on before, they're going to be resurrected out of the grave. It don't make any difference if your head is chopped off, or amen, if you're shot through the head. And God, amen, is going to resurrect that, amen, body, and you're going to have a new and glorified body. Oh, let me tell you something tonight. The heat of the furnace could not hurt Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. When the king went and he looked down in that furnace, and he seen the four down there walking around loose, the Bible said. They was loosed and they was walking around. You know why that they was in there? Because they would not worship that image that Nebuchadnezzar had set up out there in the plains, where they could see the sun glittering off that gold for miles and miles away. Amen. And then when they heard the sound of music, there was a decree that was made. When you hear this, you immediately fall on your face and you worship that image that's out there. That is going to take place again, because the Antichrist, he is the enemy of God, because he don't believe in Christ. And you know what? That the world is full of Antichrist in this day and time. Amen. And all It has to be, is this new world order to take place, and then the United Nations or the world of the 10 nations that it talks about here in Daniel, when this all takes place and this Antichrist makes an image of himself, Brother Dale. I'm talking about the one that's going to be in the temple over there. The Antichrist. I believe that God has shown me this. He's going to have an image of himself made. A robot. It's going to have artificial intelligence, which they're working on in this day and time.
Yes,
artificial intelligence. They're trying to go beyond what man is capable of doing. And then there's the God that I spoke of, that they're going to create, they find. A God, a robot with a human brain that's going to be programmed, that's going to live forever. It's going to be a God. They think that's what they're going to do. God is the God of heaven and earth.
Yes, he is.
When God said, no, the tower is going to fall just like it did in Babylon. I mean, everything that they think that they're going to do, I hope that there's some big people across the world that would hear this some way or the other. You'll only do what God says you can do, as long as he says you can do it. And then when God says, this is the end of you, he said, I raise up kings and I destroy kingdoms. And it's going to be no problem for 10 kings to rise up in that day. And it's going to be no problem for the stone that came out of the mountains to roll down and to break the toes of this image that it's talking about in the Great Tribulation days. The toes are the 10 kings. You study Daniel and it tells you plain that's what they are. The toes of clay, the toes, the feet of brass. I mean, they're made to crumble to start with. It started out with a head of gold, the arms of silver, and chest of silver. Got on down to the belly of iron, and the legs of iron, down to the feet of brass, and the toes of clay. They didn't put much foundation under this image that they was wanting to worship, but the one that's going to be created in the days of the Antichrist, he's going to be an electronic man that's going to be full of knowledge of that day, that's going to be able to draw fire down from heaven and hailstones that weighs 100 pounds. That's what the Bible says about it. He's going to be one of the biggest imitators that there ever was, but he will have an end to him. When this stone comes rolling out of Babylon, let me tell you something, and that stone is Jesus Christ, it won't be any problem for the 10 kings of that day to be destroyed. The 10 kingdoms of the earth will crumble in that day and time. You just watch and see what I'm preaching to you. If any of you is alive in that day and time, I may be, but I have kind of got the feeling, sense of week or two back, that God was going to give me at least 10 more years to minister.
Amen.
And I think he's got some traveling he wants me to do. I mean, that's then just coming up in my mind that God has got some traveling that he's wanting me to do. And oh, how exciting this can be.
Amen.
But I don't think my children are too excited about it. But with God, all things are possible.
Yes, they are.
And I know that Moses was 80 years old when God spoke to him in the burning bush. God may speak to me when I'm 82, maybe about the time I'm 83, and he may say, I want you to do a little traveling for me. If he does, until then, I'm going to be doing the very best I can do to preach to you the revelation that God has given me here in the Word of God. I want to preach to you the truth about this. Let me get back into it. I've almost covered it. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego was bound and cast into the fiery furnace. You know what happened to the men that threw them in there? The fire slew these men because it was so hot. Amen. And Nebuchadnezzar looked down in the fiery furnace and he seen Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego walking in there. And he said, I see the fourth man, and that fourth man looks like the Son of God. How did he know what the Son of God looked like? He'd never seen him, but all of a sudden, and there was a reality came into Nebuchadnezzar's mind, and he looked down there. He said, surely, undoubtedly, and no one else could be down in there. He knew the imitator couldn't be down in there because he couldn't take the heat. But this was the real thing. This was the Son of the true and the living God that was down there walking about with Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Let me tell you something tonight. The God of heaven and the God of earth has got plans, Brother Dale, and got plans for as many people as will stop and listen to him, and that he wants them to stand up and sell out to him. Amen. And stand up against all the forces of evil. Amen. On the face of this earth. Amen. Stand up and say, I am a child of God. I serve the true and the living God, the Son, which is Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Savior.
Amen.
Let me get into this. Then Nebuchadnezzar, starting at 26th verse. Then Nebuchadnezzar came near the mouth of the burning fiery furnace and spake and said, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, ye servants of the Most High God, come forth and come hither. Then Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego came forth out of the midst of the fire. And the princes, governors, and captains of the king, counselors, being gathered together, saw these men upon whose body the fire had no power. Amen. That is the God that I'm preaching about tonight.
Amen.
Don't
Amen.
Be afraid of what man can do to you.
Amen, that's right.
Let's know and realize that we're in this thing, we're soldiers in the Lord's army.
Yes, amen.
And that we're going to go through by the grace and the help of God. We're going to go through the hard times. God, Jesus was in the garden praying, but he wasn't praying that we would have a bed of roses to sleep on, Brother Dale. But it might be a bed of bricks that we, if we're really sold out to God, we may have to sleep in some rough places. I imagine that John the Baptist, when he came out of the wilderness, I imagine that his bed was the hard ground that he slept on. I imagine that his pillow may have been a rock, if he had a pillow. I imagine that he was glad when he walked up on swarm of bees, and he had to rob the bees to get some honey to eat. And I imagine that he was thankful for all the hard things that God done for him. I mean, he didn't say, "Now, Lord, why are you making me go through this?" That is the song you hear in this day and time. Why would God make me go through this? Why did we make Jesus Christ go to the cross of Calvary? We're the ones that made him go there because we wasn't worthy. And he went there to prepare the way for us. John the Baptist came out of the wilderness crying, "Prepare ye the way of the Lord." Mm-hmm. And that's exactly what we're in this for today, is to prepare the way of the Lord.
Amen.
And there's too much false preaching going on. How that God will keep us from having to go through the hardships of life. I'm here to tell you, God has took me through some hard times. But having church when a man next door was shooting just as fast as he could shoot and threatening to come and kill everyone in the church. And he told people he had aim on my head many a time. All he had to do was squeeze the trigger. But he didn't. God didn't keep him from doing that. But he didn't squeeze the trigger because God had a work. And let me tell you something. It's not God didn't say, "I'm going to lead you around the hard places." The children of Israel, they had to cross Jordan to get in the promised land. And it was at flood time when they crossed Jordan. They crossed the Red Sea when there was a wall of water on each side of them. But they crossed on dry ground when the enemy fell in behind them. That wall of water came in on them.
Amen.
And destroyed the enemy.
Amen.
We got to get our priorities straightened
yes,
out.
Amen.
I'm going with you, God.
Amen.
I'm
amen.
Going with you all the way.
Amen.
All the way, even to the end. Amen. I'm going with you, God.
Amen.
Even if I have to give my life for you, or if I have to give my life for my brother, I'm going with you, God, because I sold out to you.
Amen.
Amen.
And I'll read 27, the whole thing over. And the princes, governors, and captains, and the king's counselors being gathered together, saw these men upon whose body the fire had no power, nor was an hair of their head singed. Neither were their coats changed, nor the smell of fire had passed on them. That is the God that we serve. That is a miracle.
Amen.
That God could take them through a furnace that was heated hotter than it had ever been heated up before. And he took them through without one little evidence that they was in a hot fire. Praise God. And that this is a foreshadow of the great tribulation period. That's exactly what it's leading up to. What is going to take place in the tribulation. The image, all of it. That the commentary in this Bible, Scofield Bible, lays it out so plain and clear. Back in that day, the kingdom that was on earth, then the Roman Empire, and that been dissolved, and then us going into a one world government. That they've been trying to put in force since 1943, and that we the Christian people are going to go through the tribulation period because it's for the trying of the patience of the saints. The wrath of God is when God is mad and he pours out his wrath on this earth. I wouldn't want to be here at that time because it's going to be a bad place to be. Then Nebuchadnezzar spake and said, blessed be the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. He came to his senses one more time. Back in the beginning of this, or the end of the second chapter, he made a decree that everybody worship the God that Daniel worshiped. In the third chapter, he had built an image and put it out in the plains there for people to see, and made a decree that they had to worship that image. That's just how changeable that people are, even in this day and time. But if there's someone that is a Christian person in the government, we need to pray for them and back them up all the way. Like Brother Richard Sanders, I'm telling you, people may not agree with the way he handles his job, but any place I ever see him, he's standing up for God,
amen,
for what is right.
Amen.
And it's so scattered and far between in this day and time to find a person that is in politics that will acknowledge God. Oh, how I'd like to see from the White House backwards.
Amen.
Down this way. Everybody become Christian.
Amen.
If that happens, it won't happen because God has done said what is going to happen. But if it did happen, wouldn't this world be a great place to live? God has created. I enjoy life so much right now. I enjoy looking at what God has created for us, for our pleasure. I enjoy what he said, that man would have dominion over the fowls of the air, the fish of the sea, the animals of the field. Oh, I used to be a hunter, and I know what it means to get out there and enjoy the creation that God gave us. Margaret was one of the best wild meat cooks in the country. And if I killed a deer and brought it in, I'll guarantee you for supper that night, we'd have a mess of deer meat that was delicious. A man that works at Turnbull's now, I went Western Opto in Annapolis, and I bought some stuff up there. He said, can I deliver this for you? I bought a riding mower, a garden tiller, and some other stuff. And they walked in the house when they delivered the stuff, and they said, what is that cooking? Said, that smells, oh, said, that smells so delicious. And I think she gave them a plate. I know she gave them a sample of it. I asked him the other day, I said, do you remember when I used to come up there and buy all that stuff? He said, yes, I remember that. But that's getting off the subject. But God is good. That is the subject. God is good. And the God that I'm preaching about, the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, is the God of Range Creek Church. I mean,
amen.
There is the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost that we serve. The Holy Ghost dwells in here.
Yes.
We dwell in the Father through the Son.
Amen.
And all three becomes one in him.
Amen.
So We're so blessed tonight.
Amen.
Where did I get to? 29?
No, you didn't finish 28.
Okay. Then Nebuchadnezzar spake and said, Blessed be the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, who has sent his angel and delivered his servants that trust in him and have changed the king's world and yielded their bodies that they might not serve nor worship any god except their own god. I'm going to quit there, and I'll probably preach on this some more before it's over. You know, this goes all the way through the 7th chapter. I might be preaching on this when I resign from here next year. That depends on the Lord and all you guys, but I'm going to start mentioning that every once in a while because I've got plans that God's been speaking to me on, and they might seem too big for most of you, but they're too big for me, but they're not too big for God. Praise God. I love him so much tonight, and I do appreciate his goodness, his love,
Amen.
And his mercy, and oh, how great he is tonight.
Amen.
How can we not love him after all that he's done for us?
Amen.
I mean,
Amen.
He is a God of love.
Amen.
He wouldn't have sacrificed his son for the sins of the world. For God so loved the world, and the world wasn't even fitting to be loved. But neither was I when Jesus walked in a dream in my house. Put his hand on my back and said, Trust me, son. Just trust me. I mean, we live in North Cypress on Mallon Cross Street from Johnny Lund off Bowling Alley. Every Sunday I spent in the bowling alley. Instead of being in church, I spent my time over there rolling the ball down the alley to see how many pins I could knock over. That's so empty and void now. But what is really my life is God.
Amen.
I want to be sold out to him.
Amen.
I don't care how old, Brother Carl, I get. I want to be sold out to God.
Amen.
When I die, I want to say, there was a man that was sold out to God.
Yes, amen.
Praise the Lord. Amen. I'm going to close, and it's been a joy, a blessing. Brother Dale, you'll get your turn up here. I promise. Sometime. No, you will. I promise you that. But, oh, what can I say? There's not enough that can be said
Amen.
About Jesus Christ.
Amen.
How thankful I am that he led me to this altar.
Yes,
right
amen.
Here in front of this pulpit.
Amen.
And Margaret's prayers was answered that
yes.
night. 25 years she'd been praying for me. I saw the light. Praise God. Okay. If all minds is clear, if anybody's got anything on your heart, speak up. If not, a stand will be dismissed. Thank you.